Good morning. Welcome to Christ the Ark Church. Stay tuned and enjoy the service with us.
Verse is Jeremiah 29 verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. We can all be men in Christ.
I am a man in Christ. And my favorite verse is Psalm 143 verse 8. Let me hear your unfailing love in the morning, for I am trusting in you. Show me where to walk, for I give myself to you. We can all be men in Christ. Amen.
Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I just want to rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just want to thank my pastor for this opportunity that he has awarded me, that I can come before you today and minister the word of God. But before I continue, we are going to pray and ask the Lord to lead us. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I come before your throne of grace. I pray, Almighty God, that you will lead me and direct me. I pray that the Holy Spirit will come upon me and preach through me the good tidings of the word of God. In the name of our Lord God and Savior, Father, I thank you. I honor you and I reverence you. I know that I cannot speak on my own, but with you leading me and directing me, I will speak with boldness. I will speak the word of God. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Today is a very special day. It is Father's Day, and I just want to wish all the fathers a happy, happy Father's Day. May you continue to channel your family in the right path of God. May you continue to be the champions of your little ones. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord lead you and direct you. May the Lord come upon you and show you favor and show you his grace always. And know that it is not by power nor by might, but it is by the grace of God that you are able to find yourself having been called a father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Happy Father's Day. And without any waste of time, I'll be going directly to my message. And I have entitled my message under the topic, How Will This Be? It is a question, how will this be? This is a question that was asked by many men and women in the Word of God. Those people, they were encountering situations that they were not sure if it will come to pass. They were not sure of, because of the magnitude of the situation that they were coming across. But they asked this question, how will this be, O Lord? The first woman that we are going to read up, but the first man that we are going to read about who asked this question, it is Zechariah. We will find that in the book of Luke chapter 1, verse 5 to 13, and also 18 to 19. If you found it, it reads as follows. In the time of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah who belonged to the priestly division of Abijah. His wife Elizabeth was also a descendant of Aaron. Both of them were righteous in the sight of God, observing all the Lord's commands and decree blamelessly. But they were childless because Elizabeth was not able to conceive, and they were both very old. Once when Zechariah's division was on duty and he was serving as a priest before God, he was chosen by lot, according to the customs of the priesthood, to go into the temple of the Lord and burn incense. And when the time for the burning of incense came, all the assembled worshippers were praying outside. Verse 11. Then an angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing at the right side of the altar of incense. When Zechariah saw him, he was startled and was gripped with fear. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah. Your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you are to call him John." Now we go to verse 18. Zechariah asked the angel, "How can I be sure of this? I am an old man, and my wife is well along in years." The angel said to him, "I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and to tell you this good news." Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Zechariah asked the question, how will this be? He stated the fact that he was very old and his wife was also well along in years. The good news came that he had been praying about. The good news was delivered by an angel of God when he was praying, when he was doing the work of the Lord. But yet he asked the question, how will this be? He couldn't believe that it was finally happening. We can't blame him. If we assess the situation as well, and we look at him, we know how will this be. Yes, you have prayed, but you're asking yourself, how will this be? Right in that situation, maybe you have received a prophetic word. Yes, you have been prophesied. You will receive a child. You will get that job. You will be healed. But when you look at the yes, it has been long. And you are wondering, how will this be, O Lord? Your situation has nothing to do with who you are before God. Whether you speak in tongues or not, whether you are a pastor or you are an usher, but it has everything to do with what God wants to do in your life. Zachariah and his wife were righteous before God, but still, they went through the situation of being childless. Regardless of their status, they went through a situation of barrenness. I don't know what you're going through in your life. I don't know what you're faced with in your life. You might be sitting there asking yourself, but my situation, how will it be? When it has to come to pass, how will it be? We will find the answer very soon. Let us go and look into this other woman who was also faced with a situation where she asked the angel, how will this be? This woman was Mary, the mother of Jesus. If we look in the same book, Luke chapter 1, from verses 28 to 35, it's just further down where we were reading. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his father David." Mary is listening to all this. She's maybe wondering, the throne of his father David. But she is not even understanding this, what the angel is saying. She's not even, trying to contemplate whose father? Who is David? But she's listening. "And he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." Then Mary comes and responds in verse 34. "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel. "Since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." Hallelujah. The Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Mary's situation was just on another level. She was already spoken for by Joseph. But here, the angel is telling her that this child that she's going to bear, he's going to sit on his father's throne, David. And if we know in the word of God, Joseph is the one that is in the lineage of David. Little did Mary know when the angel came. All she was thinking in her mind was, how will this be? How is my life going to turn out? This situation is going to bring, a whole lot of unscrambled things in my life. This situation is going to change my life forever. And not for the good, mind you. Because she was already spoken for. She was about to be married. And who have ever heard of a virgin having a child? It had never happened. But because the angel had delivered the good news, the angel came and said, it is going to be the way that he has explained. Why? Let's now look at the let's now look at this situation. You might be in some situation which is too complex that you yourself, you cannot explain yourself out of it. You try to explain to people, this is what is happening in my life, but they don't have solutions for you. They don't even know how to tell you how to get out of it. You are in this situation, but what you need to do is to fix your eyes on God. What you need to do is to hold on unto the word of God. That's what Mary did. She held on to the word of God. She went in the verses to come there. In verse 38, I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your word to me be fulfilled. Then the angel left her. You are sitting there, you are asking yourself, I don't know how this situation is going to stop. I don't know how this situation is going to come to an end. How, Lord? For how long, Lord? You've been asking yourself. Now we're going to, before we get to the answers, we're going to look at this last couple. It was Sarah and Abraham in the book of Genesis chapter 18, verse 9 to 13. This couple, they were also righteous before the Lord. God found favor in them. They found favor in God. It's Genesis chapter 18 from verse 9. That this is was after Abraham had prepared food for the angels that had visited them. And one of the angels asked, where is your wife Sarah? They asked him. There in the tent, he said. Then one of them said, I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah, your wife, will have a son. Now Sarah was listening at the entrance of the tent, which was behind him. Abraham and Sarah were already very old, and Sarah was past the age of childbearing. So Sarah laughed to herself as she thought, after I am worn out and my Lord is old, will I now have this pleasure? Yeah, the things that God can do. Then the Lord said to Abraham, why did Sarah laugh and say, will I really have a child now that I am old? Hallelujah. Sarah, she was really puzzled by this word. They've been praying. She wanted a child. She even gave her husband to another woman. That's how desperately she wanted to create an heir for her husband. But when the news came, Sarah forgot about her prayer. And the first thing that came to her mind, Sarah laughed. Sarah laughed. Some of you might be laughing like Sarah at your situations. When you read the word of God, you're thinking, will this really come to pass? When you encounter the Spirit of God, when you come in contact with the word with the Lord in His word, you ask yourself, how will this be, Lord? Can my situation be like Sarah? Can my situation be like Mary? Can my situation be like Elizabeth's situation? I'm here to tell you that all things are possible with God. Mm-hmm. All things are possible with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. After visiting so many doctors, will my situation ever change? Will I ever get the healing that I need? Yes. It is not like others. Your situation needs a godly intervention. Your situation needs God Himself to send His angel. Hallelujah. Amen. Because the Holy Spirit must first come upon you. Then your situation will change. If we continue reading in Luke chapter 1 and go to verse 37, we will find our why there. Hallelujah. Amen. Luke chapter 1 in verse 37. That is where our why is situated. For no word from God will ever fail. We might ask ourselves, how will this be? How will my situation change? How will my situation turn from this impossible state that it is at and become what God is saying it will be? It is because it is written in His word in Luke chapter 1, verse 37, for no word from God will ever fail. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No word from God will ever fail.
Mm.
Let's also look at Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. Jesus looked at them and said, with men, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, with men, with doctors, with prophets, things are impossible, but with God, all things are possible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we shield ourselves with the love and the word of God, all things will be possible.
Mm-hmm.
When we stand on the word of God without wavering, all things will be possible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we stand and declare the word of God over and over and say, my situation will change. My situation next year about this time, my situation is not going to be the same.
Mm.
And not laugh like Sarah and believe the angel of God when he comes. Indeed, all things will never be the same.
Mm.
All things will be possible. Our pastor, Pastor Titi, he once shared this powerful message in the book of Isaiah, verse 40. In the book of Isaiah 40, verse 31. It says in the Amplified Version, but those who wait for the Lord, who expect, look for, and hope in Him, will gain new strength and renew their power.
Mm.
Those who expect, who look for, and hope in Him will gain new strength and renew their power.
Mm.
He said we will get new strength.
Mm.
Strength that has never been used before.
Mm.
Strength that is that has weighed your situation. And the strength that is new just for you. You will get that strength when you hope on the Lord. Hallelujah.
Mm.
When you trust in God with all your heart. Not leaning on your own understanding.
Mm.
Not leaning on what you have read in magazines.
Mm.
Not leaning on what you've read in the internet. But when you trust in the word of God,
mm.
all things will be possible.
Mm-hmm.
You will stand like Sarah and say, my Lord, let it be as you have said.
Mm.
You will not have doubt in your heart.
Yeah.
You will not have doubt in your mind
mm.
that indeed I serve a great God. How will this be? You will ask yourself. Those who expect, who look for,
mm.
and who hope in Him,
mm.
those are the ones who will get new strength.
Mm.
Those are the ones that when they're trying to, when the situations around them
mm.
is drowning them, is getting them to be weary, they will stand and say, not if the Lord is by my side.
Mm.
By the word of God, and what the Lord has said in His word, in Luke 1 verse 37, for no word from God will ever fail.
Mm.
If you stand upon the word of God, no word from God will ever fail.
Mm.
He said it, that whatever word comes out, it will never go back void.
Mm.
So declare it. Continue to declare the word of God. Continue to declare the power that is in His word. And you will see your situations changing. They will ask, how will this be, O Lord?
Mm.
And because they don't hope in their own abilities,
mm.
because they don't hope in their own financial means,
mm.
they will get what has been promised in the word of God.
Mm.
Let's stand on the word of God. Let's stand on the promises of God and see if our situations will not change. I don't know what situation you are facing today. That one that you have put on the, even in your prayer items, it is still on your, in your 2018 prayer request.
Mm.
I want you to move it to 2020 prayer request.
Mm.
I want you to go and write it again in your prayer book, in the 2020 prayer book, and say, Even this situation, I am giving it to God. I am not going to give up on this situation. It looked hopeless. A virgin getting a child. It looked hopeless. An old woman bearing a child. But I'm here to tell you, there is no situation that is hopeless when we fix our eyes in God. When we put it before God. Our pastor was ministering last week that get up and walk. He was saying to this situation, it doesn't matter how long you have sat with that situation, but it is time for you to get up and walk. It is time for you to pick up all that belongs to you and say, I am following my Father. I am following the Lord of God. I am going to stand on the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you begin to understand the God that you serve, you start to see things differently. You start to experience life differently. Even situations that are weighing on your shoulders, you are able to stand on His word and say, my situation will change. My situation will not be impossible. Only if I bring God into my situation will then things start to turn around. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to stand on the word of God. Your situation is not like your friend, yes. Your situation is not like your colleague, yes. You have been waiting for that promotion for a very long time. You have been waiting for that upliftment. You submit all your projects on time. But your situation remained the same. You are waiting on your angel. You need the divine intervention. Your situation, it needs the angel himself to come upon you. The Holy Spirit to come and overshadow you. Do not look down upon your situation. Do not look down upon the word of God that came out through that prophecy. Through you reading the word yourself. Don't look down upon it, my sister. Don't look down upon it, my brother. It will surely come to pass. You might be asking yourself, how will this be? How will this be? It has been long, yes. You have moved from doctor to doctor, yes. But I'm here to reassure you of the power that is in the word of God. I am here to reassure you of the power that is in the oracles of the Most High God. No word from Him shall ever fail. No word from God shall ever fail. If we stand on His word, if we depend on His word, like Mary, she assessed her situation. Like Zachariah, yes, he was praying. Yes, he was righteous before God. He was a servant of God. But his situation, it was weighing down on his heart. His situation was, it was heavy on him. It was like he could walk around and say, Lord, my situation is like no other. I see the other priests, they have sons. I see the other priests, they have children. But his situation was not changing. But yet it did not stop him to worship the Lord. It did not stop him from serving the Lord. My brother, my sister, never stop serving the Lord. Amidst that situation, arise. Arise and say, my situation, one day it will be like for those that it has come to pass on. Continue to submit those projects on in time. Continue to wake up at the midnight hour and worship the Lord. Continue to sing praises unto His living name. Your situation will not be like this forever. God will change it. An angel will come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This was because it was not something ordinary. What you're facing is not something ordinary. It is not like so and so situation.
Yeah.
Your situation, it needs, it does not need physical strength. Your situation, it does not need, financial breakthroughs. It needs a divine intervention. It needs a divine intervention from the Holy One. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If we look at the book of John, chapter 4, verses 24, the Bible says, "For God is spirit, and he seeks such to worship him in truth and in spirit." We are serving a God who is spirit. We are not serving a God who is physical. Mm-hmm. When we are walking, we can now, even the other people can see that now this one is walking with God. They can see God walking next to you. No. You are serving a God who is spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, he seeks such who will worship him in truth and in spirit. He seeks such that when they are going through the situation, they will look at his word. They will go and read and search the word of God. Mm. What does it say about my situation? Mm. Yes, God is not there. God is not anywhere when you are reading, but his spirit comes upon you. Mm. His spirit overshadows you. And you know deep down in your heart, you get reassured that my situation will change. You will then go and testify, I have encountered the Lord. I might be walking right now and my situation is known by everyone. My situation is seen by everyone. And I'm walking with boldness because I know that I serve a great God.
Yeah.
I know that this God that I am serving, he will turn things around for me.
Mm-hmm.
He will turn things around for me.
Mm-hmm.
And when it happened, it will be like a dream. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When it come to pass,
Amen.
It will be like a dream.
Amen.
But God will surely come through for you. But God will surely come through for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because it was not done by an ordinary man. We do not serve an ordinary man. We do not serve the Baal. Huh? These gods that the Egyptians were serving. No. Even the Israelites, they knew we serve a great God.
Mm-hmm.
They were shadowed by the cloud by day,
mm-hmm.
and shadowed by the pillar of fire by night. That was the Holy Spirit shadowing them when they left Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Can your situation ever be impossible for your God? Mm-hmm. Ask yourself that. Immediately when you start thinking, my situation, this one is too deep. My situation, this one, it cannot be possible. Yes, Jesus said also in the book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 26.
Mm.
But Jesus looked at them and said,
mm-hmm.
When people, with people, as far as it depends on them, as far as it depends on them, it is impossible.
Mm.
But with God, all things are possible. So let's stop looking at our situation in people's physical eyes. Let's stop looking at our situation in our carnal eyes, in our physical eyes, and look at God. Let's look at what God has done for us in the past. Let's look at the examples that we have in the Word of God. The example of Elizabeth. The example of Sarah. The example of the Shunammite woman. We have so many examples in the Word of God. Let's focus on what God is doing. Let's focus on the possibility of the power of God. If we stand in His Word, we know that all things will be possible. Jesus said it himself, that as far as it depends on them, as far as it depends on you, as far as it depends on your own strength, as far as it depends in your own ability, yes, it will be impossible, my sister. Yes, it will be impossible, my brother. But as far as we depend upon the power from above, as far as we depend upon God himself, all things will be possible. All things will come to pass. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will be asking yourself this, how will this be? You will try to imagine. You will try to contemplate different ways on how you can come out of your financial breakdowns. You can try to say, I'll move this to here, I'll move this from here, I'll even stop typing, I'll even stop doing this and that. But it needs God's intervention. It needs God himself. If you put it before God, I am telling you, your situation will never be the same. Your situation is bound to change. Maybe you have a promise from his word. You were reading that all things are possible, but you don't know how it will be. I'm here to reassure you. Leave that to God. An angel will come and the Holy Spirit will come upon you. That is how it will be. That is how it will be. Fix your eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith. He is the one that will encourage you. He is the one that will cheer you on. He is the one that will turn your situation around. Who would have thought that after Mary had gone through what she had gone through, she would even end up getting married and even having other children? Joseph was in the lineage of David. He was the father of Jesus. Hallelujah. The angel came and told it to her, but she did not understand. There might be things that you've read in his word. There might be things that you've encountered when you had a one-on-one with God, but still you don't understand how it will all plan out, how it will all work out. But I'm here to tell you, with God, all things are possible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's say this all together. With God, all things are possible.
With God, all things are possible.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to pray. Maybe you've been walking around in your life and you know, like Nicodemus, you need God in your life. You've been walking around. If you look at the book of the book of John. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm trying to find my scripture about the situation of Nicodemus, because he also encountered and asked Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. John 3. Hallelujah. He asked God, how will this be? Because he wanted to be born again. He saw the life of Jesus. He experienced that love that Jesus had for people. When Jesus was going around healing people, hallelujah, he also asked, how will this be? You might be sitting there and you don't know Jesus. You might be sitting there and you want to encounter him. You want to have a relationship with him. You want him to turn your situations around. It is possible if you accept him as your Lord and Savior. Right where you are, allow him to come into your heart. Allow him to speak positively into your heart. Allow him to change your situation. Be like Nicodemus today and receive him as your Lord and Savior and be born again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to pray right now as I conclude my message. We are going to pray to the Father. We are going to pray to the Lord who hears. To the Lord who is seated in his throne, watching over you. We are going to pray that, Lord, how will this be? How can I be born again? How can I experience the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit? It can only be possible if you lean on God, if you trust in God, if you allow him to come into your heart. Let us go and pray and know that in Mark chapter 9 verse 23, if you can, said Jesus, everything is possible for one who believes. Just believe in God, believe in him, trust in him, and it will also be possible to you.
Amen.
It will also be possible for your situation. Let us go and pray as I conclude. Father, you know what they're going through. You know our situations one by one. You know those deep down prayers that we have prayed. You know, Almighty God, those times that we came before your throne of grace and wailed before you, Almighty God. Wailed like Hannah did. You are the only one who can change our situation. We thank you right now for your word, O Father God, that you are changing our situations around. We may continue to ask ourselves, how will this be? But now we know that it will be when we lean on God's understanding. When we know that God is ruling over our hearts. When we know that all things are possible with God. When we know, Almighty God, that the angel will come and deliver good news. When we know that you are watching over us. You said in your way that you will never leave us nor forsake us. You will be with us every step of the way. We are casting all our burdens unto you right now, mighty God. We are leaning on God's word. We are leaning on your word. Not in our own understanding anymore. Because our understanding is limited, oh God. But when we sit under your guidance, when we read your word, may the revelations come. May your word be cleared out in our hearts. And may we follow you, Jesus. May we follow you, Jesus. May we follow you, Jesus, in everything that we do. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, I pray for each and every person that is watching. I pray, Almighty God, to those that are saying yes to you, Lord, now. I'm saying, Lord, come into their hearts. Change their situation. Come into their hearts right now as we pray, Almighty God, and let their situations change. Let them hope on the Lord. Let their faith be an anchor to you, Almighty God, to trusting in you. In the mighty name of our Lord God and Savior, Father, we bring all these situations before your throne of grace, and we trust and believe in your way. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Let us continue to trust in the Lord. Let us continue to depend only on his word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have come to the end of our service. We have missed you. We love you. And we wish we can gather again with you believers and sing and praises unto the Lord and trust God together as we walk this journey of faith, because it can only be possible when we trust in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you want to give unto Christ the Ark, to partner with us in taking the word to the ends of the earth, may you see the following screen, and may the Lord richly bless you as you give towards this ministry. Amen and amen.
Amen.